Hello friends, today we are going to discuss a topic, linear equation in two variable. Let us see what is mean by an equation. Equation is a statement of equality. I said a statement that a plate carry total 10 number of vegetable. The two vegetables are tomato and mango. So total is 10. A plate carries total 10 number of tomato and mango. So I represent tomato by T and mango by M is equal to 10. It is a statement of equality. It is called an equation. Now it carries two letter. So that's why it is equation in two variable. The degree of the variable is 1. Let us represent tomato by a letter X and another letter mangoes represent by a letter Y, and both is equal to 10. So you can see here a plate carries two object, tomato and mango, both is equal to 10. So this is a statement of equality, is called equation. It has two variable, the degree of the variable is 1. That's why it is linear equation in two variable. Now to solve this equation, it is only a one equation. Now let us see one equation has how many answer. You can easily, suppose I ask this, keep 10, represent 10, total is 10. You can say, sir, one number is 1, another is 9. 1 plus 9 is 10. So tomato is 1. Another answer is 4 and 6. Another answer is 6 and 4. So it is not a, it has infinite solution. Now to get the specific answer, let us add one more condition. Another condition is that number of tomato is 4 more than mango. 4 more. 4 more means the difference between these two is 4. The difference between these two is 4. Tomato has 4 more than mangoes. Now let us see how to solve these two equations. First of all, write this equation one below another. After writing these two equations, you come to know that Y has plus and minus sign. The coefficient of Y is 1, also coefficient of X is 1. Simply by adding these two, you will get that plus y minus y get cancelled. Here you will get 1x plus 1x, 2x is equal to 14. 2x is equal to 14, therefore x is equal to rules of equation. Multiply goes to that side in division. 14 divided by 2, it becomes 7. So you will be getting x is equal to 7. It means number of tomato is 7. Put this value in equation 1, in any equation. Our first equation is x plus y is 10. Value of x is 7. So you will get value of y is equal to plus, transfer to right hand side, it becomes minus. 10 minus 7 is equal to 3. So you got two answers. X is 7 and Y is 3. You can declare the answer. The solution of given equation is 7 and 3. Let us count. The number of tomato, you can see it here. It is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And number of mango is equal to 3. So, it is the way how to solve linear equation. It is first method, elimination method. Let us see another example. Let us discuss one more problem by elimination method. The pair of linear equation is written here. It is first equation. 5x plus 3y is equal to minus 11 and 2x plus 4y is equal to minus 10. It is second equation. To discuss elimination method, we have to eliminate one of the variables. I decided to eliminate y. Now let us see the coefficient of y. Here is 3 and another coefficient is 4. Now to first of all make both coefficients same. To make both coefficients same, this 3 is multiplied by 4 and 4 is multiplied by 3. When you do multiplication, both become 12. Here the coefficient is 3 and 4. That's why we multiplied it by 4 and 3. If the coefficients are 2 and 6, then it is very simple. You have to find out the common number 3. You multiply 2 by 3 and 6 by 1. No need to multiply 2 by 6 and 6 by 2. So, give the command multiplying whole equation 1 by 4 and whole equation 2 by 3. So, it becomes 5 4s are 20x plus 12y is equal to minus 44. And here when you go on multiplying all three number 2, 4 and minus 10, it become 6x plus 12y is equal to minus 30. What happened here? Both coefficients are equal. Y is same. But see the sign. Both are plus plus. So 12 plus 12, it becomes 24. So we have to give command subtracting second equation from the first. For that, you have to change the sign of each number. By changing this sign, plus become minus. Minus become plus. So what happened here? Now the new sign becomes minus, minus and plus. Plus 12 and minus 12, it is eliminated, it becomes 0. And here, 20 and minus 6, it becomes how much? 14x is equal to minus 14. 1 is plus and minus. You can go with subtraction. X equal to minus 14 upon 14. The answer is x is equal to minus 1. After getting one of the values, substitute this value in any one of the equation. You will, when you replace x from 1, write down first equation 5x, but do not write x now. Replace x by minus 1 plus 3y is equal to minus 11. Minus 5 plus 3y is equal to minus 11. 3y equal to, transfer minus 5 to the right hand side, it becomes plus. Minus 11 plus 5, it becomes minus 6. So you will be getting 3y equal to minus 6, y equal to minus 6 by 3. And the values of y is minus 2. So you will be getting two answer. Value of x is equal to minus 1 and y is equal to minus 2. Lastly, declare the solution of given equation is minus 1 and minus 2. Note it down this and apply this method to solving different type of questions. Let us see to solve linear equation in two variable by another method. Name of that method is by Cramer's rule. Cramer's rule is a method of determinant. Let us see what is mean by determinant. Let determinant it represent by a D letter. Determinant is an arrangement. So to solve string equation by this method, write three letter. One letter is D, another letter is D of X, and the third letter is D of Y. While writing, write down X here in the suffix properly, D of X and D of Y. What to write here in D? First of all, write the equation in this pattern, AX plus BY equal to C. Note it down the question in this pattern, AX plus BY equal to C. What is A, B and C? This A, B and C are real number and X and Y are the variable. What to write down here? Write down the coefficient of X and Y. What is coefficient of X here? The coefficient of X here is 5 and 2. What is coefficient of Y? 3 and 4. Now, while writing D of X, do not write the coefficient of x. but write down coefficient of 1. While writing d of y, do not write the coefficient of y. What I did it here, see. First of all, write down d in this pattern. While writing d of x, do not write x, write down y. While writing d of y, do not write coefficient of y, but write down coefficient of x. Now, what to write down here? Write down the last number, c1 and c2. This number, minus 11 and minus 10. What to write it down here in d of y? Do not write of y. So what you write? Minus 11 upon minus 10. In this way, you can frame this three frame here, d, d of x and d of y. How to solve this? While solving, just go on cross multiply. It is very easy. You all know how to do cross multiply. Everywhere you go for cross multiplication. While cross multiplication, write down the left hand side top number first. 5 multiplied by 4. And here you write down 3 multiplied by 2. And insert a minus sign here. Go for multiplication. 5 fours are 20 minus 6 is equal to, you will get 14. Do it here again, same cross multiply. Left hand side, top quarter number, write down as it is, minus 11 into 4. Write down 3 multiplied by minus 10. Again, here is a minus sign. It is a formula method. Write down it here, minus number. Go with the simple calculation. 11 fours are 44, 10 threes are 30. Minus and minus, it becomes plus. Again, minus 44 divided by plus 30, it becomes minus 14. Carry on it here also. You can notice 5 into minus 10 minus of minus 11 into 2. Here you will be getting minus 50 plus 22. How much is the answer? 8 and 18. Minus 28. After getting this three value, write down the value of x is equal to d of x divided by d and y is equal to d of y divided by d. What is d of x? Minus 14 divided by d. Value of d is 14. So, minus 1. Here, d of y is equal to minus 28 and value of is d is 14, then it becomes y equal to minus 2. Again, you notice that the answer is minus 1 and minus 2. You can write it is a solution. So, we have did today the same questions in two methods. Earlier method is elimination method and it is a Cramer rule in examination. It is definitely asked, if it is asked singly, find the value of determinant, then it is of 1 mark. If the whole question is asked, then it is of 3 marks. So, please children, note it down. And now I am giving it to you, 2 questions as an homework. Both the question you solve it by elimination method as well as by Cramer's rule. Note down the 2 questions. Now student, note it down both the questions and solve it by both the method. So 2 questions by elimination method and these 2 questions by Cramer's rule. Thank you. Have a nice day.